Hi everyone. Today in this video we are going to discuss about metoprolol. What is this drug metoprolol? We can observe the suffix olol, which indicates this drug is a beta blocker, but here metoprolol is a selective beta blocker. We can observe few of the other selective beta blockers such as etanolol, acebutolol, esmolol, nebivolol, betaxolol. All these are selective beta blockers. But here the suffix olol is also common for non-selective beta blockers. So by using this suffix, we cannot identify whether the drug is cardio-selective or non-selective. And this drug is going to block beta 1 receptors, which are located on the heart. So today in this video, we are going to discuss about this metoprolol, how this drug acts, what are the important precautions, drug interactions, side effects of this drug, when it is used for cardiovascular disorders. What is the chemical nature of this drug? So this is the structure of metoprolol, and all the beta blockers are aryl oxypropanol amines. We can observe the propyl chain here, 1, 2, 3, which is attached with the amine as well as OH group at the second position. So they are also called as propanol amines. And on the amine, we can observe a bulky chain. This bulky group is responsible for the increased beta selectivity. That's why metoprolol is a selective beta 1 blocker. Now let us see how this drug acts. Metoprolol is a selective beta blocker. It is going to block beta 1 receptors. These beta 1 receptors are present on the heart. By blocking these beta 1 receptors, metoprolol decreases the rate of contraction of the heart. It decreases the force of contraction. And when both rate as well as force of contraction are reduced, the cardiac output is also reduced. And when there is decreased cardiac output and decreased rate and force of contraction, the cardiac oxygen consumption is reduced. And by all of these, cardiac work is reduced. And when there is less load to the cardiac system, the cardiac efficiency increases. In this way, metoprolol is going to reduce the cardiac work, thereby increase the cardiac efficiency. That's why this drug is useful in the many type of cardiovascular disorders. And this drug also reduces the afterload by reducing the cardiac output. It also reduces preload slightly. And because of decreasing the afterload and somewhat preload, it can reduce the blood pressure. That's why metoprolol is also used as antihypertensive agent. But all of these actions of metoprolol are mainly attributed to its action on beta 1 receptors. So at the heart, beta 1 receptors are present, which are the receptors for catecholamines. And these beta 1 receptors are G protein coupled receptors. They are coupled with 3 subunit alpha, beta, gamma. When the catecholamines like norepinephrine or epinephrine bind to these beta 1 receptors, they stimulate the heart. These catecholamines can bind to beta 1 receptors, which are G protein coupled receptors acting through the alpha subunit. So when this alpha subunit is stimulated, they will activate adenylyl cyclase system. This adenylyl cyclase is the one of the enzyme which can convert the ATP into one of the secondary messenger cyclic AMP. So here cyclic AMP plays an important role in the stimulation of the heart. This cyclic AMP can stimulate a set of phosphorylating enzymes, protein kinase A. These enzymes can phosphorylate via the ion channel such that the intracellular calcium levels are increased. Particularly, they can increase the release of calcium from the sarcoplasmic reticulum, or they can also increase the calcium entry into the cardiac muscle. By all of these, calcium levels are increased within the cardiac muscle. And when the calcium levels are increased, it leads to the contraction of the cardiac muscle. Within the cardiac muscle, actin fibers as well as myosin fibers are present. And sliding of these two fibers is going to be prevented by troponin. Now the calcium can bind with this troponin such that the block is removed and actin filaments can be released, and they can slide on each other to produce a contraction of the cardiac muscle. In this way, norepinephrine can produce a contraction of the cardiac muscle by increasing the cyclic AMP activity. Now the metoprolol acts as an antagonist at the beta 1 receptors. It can bind to these beta 1 receptors. It inhibits the beta 1 receptor activity and inhibits the cardiac contraction. So when the cardiac muscle is not contracted, both rate as well as force of contraction is reduced, resulting in the decreased cardiac output and decreased cardiac work and increased cardiac efficiency. That's why metoprolol is useful in cardiovascular disorders like cardiac arrhythmias, angina, hypertension, and even at a low dose in the treatment of heart failure. What are the precautions? One of the important precautions is that metoprolol is going to block the beta 1 receptors, and when these beta 1 receptors are blocked, it reduces the rate of contraction as well as force of contraction of the heart. Then how this drug can be useful in the treatment of congestive heart failure? We know that congestive heart failure is a condition where there is decreased cardiac output because of the reduced force of contraction of the heart. In such conditions, we have to use the drugs which increase the force of contraction. But here metoprolol is going to reduce the force of contraction. Then how it is useful in the congestive heart failure? Even this drug is going to reduce force of contraction, but because of this inhibitory action on the heart, it reduces the cardiac work, thereby increase the cardiac efficiency, such that it can relieve the symptoms of congestive heart failure. That's why metoprolol is one of the beta blocker that can be used in the treatment of heart failure. But when this drug is used at a high dose, it can further increase the congestive heart failure. That's why metoprolol should be used at a low dose possible in the treatment of heart failure. But when the dose of the drug is going to be increased, during the increments of the dose, there may be risk of worsening of the heart failure because of decreased force of contraction and decreased cardiac output. So in such conditions, diuretics are more preferred instead of the increase in the dose of metoprolol. Second precaution. Metoprolol is going to reduce the cardiac work. That's why it is useful in the treatment of heart failure. And it also reduces the cardiac oxygen consumption. Therefore, it is reducing the angina. But when this drug is going to be suddenly stopped, then it can increase the angina. And when this angina is going to be increased, it reduces the cardiac oxygen supply, resulting in the ischemia. And when the ischemia is going to be developed, it results in the damage to the cardiac cells, resulting in myocardial infarction. In this way, metoprolol can increase the cardiovascular disorders when it is suddenly stopped. So the drug should not be stopped suddenly, and the dose should be slowly tapered in order to prevent rebound cardiovascular disorders. Metoprolol mainly blocks beta 1 receptors which are present on the heart. That's why this drug is called as cardio-selective beta blocker, and it shows very little activity on the beta 2 receptors. These beta 2 receptors are present on the various smooth muscles, including bronchial smooth muscle. But when this metoprolol is used at high dose, it can block beta 2 receptors, resulting in increased bronchospasm. So patients who are taking high dose of metoprolol, the symptoms of bronchospasm such as difficulty in breathing, wheezing should be carefully monitored in order to prevent bronchospastic disorders. Similarly, precaution should be taken in the patients suffering with pheochromocytoma. This is one of the adrenal tumor which is going to produce the catecholamines like epinephrine as well as norepinephrine. These catecholamines can act on the adrenergic receptors. They can act on the alpha 1 receptors which are present on the vascular smooth muscle. So when these receptors are activated, it results in the vasoconstriction. So it increases the blood pressure. And when it acts on the beta 1 receptors which are present on the heart, it increases the rate and force of contraction of the heart. So in order to block the vasoconstriction and cardiac stimulation because of pheochromocytoma, we can use the two drugs, alpha blockers as well as beta blockers. So here beta blocker like metoprolol can be used. When this metoprolol is initially used, it can inhibit the actions of catecholamines on the heart. Thereby, it can increase the actions of catecholamines on the alpha 1 receptors, resulting in vasoconstriction, and this results in the increased blood pressure. So this can be prevented by use of alpha blockers before the metoprolol. So metoprolol should not be initiated before the alpha blockers. Otherwise, it will produce a sudden rise in the blood pressure because of increased alpha 1 activity. Similarly, metoprolol, when it is given at a high dose, it can produce few of the conditions such as hypotension, reduce the blood pressure, and it increases the rate of contraction, resulting in the bradycardia. and it can also precipitate stroke at a high dose. So before major surgery, the metoprolol should not be used at high dose because it can precipitate hypotension, bradycardia and stroke in the patients. Similarly, when this metoprolol is suddenly withdrawn, it can produce few of the side effects such as hypoglycemia, and this hypoglycemia may induce tachycardia in the patients. Generally, when the patient is under the treatment of metoprolol, this tachycardia is going to be masked because metoprolol reduces the rate of contraction of the heart. But when this drug is suddenly withdrawn, it can increase the tachycardia induced by hypoglycemia. This is particularly important in the diabetic patients. Similarly, it can also increase the thyroid storm when it is suddenly stopped. And finally, metoprolol can also antagonize the actions of epinephrine. So this epinephrine can be used for treatment of anaphylactic shock. In such conditions, metoprolol can reduce the efficiency of epinephrine, thereby it can increase the allergic reactions. What are the side effects? The important side effects of metoprolol are related to the beta blocking activity. It produces bradycardia because it decreases the rate of contraction of the heart. It produces some drowsiness by central action. It produces fatigue as well as shortness of breath because of its action on the beta 2 receptors. And this is observed at high dose. And it can also produce hypotension. That's why it is used as antihypertensive agent. And some skin rashes can also be observed with this metoprolol. What are the drug interactions? Metoprolol is going to be metabolized by cytochrome P450 system, and among these CYP2D6 is one of the important enzyme. So few of the drugs like quinidine, which is a class 1 antiarrhythmic agent, and propafenone, again the class 1 antiarrhythmic agent. Similarly, antidepressants like paroxetine, fluoxetine, all these drugs can inhibit the CYP2D6 activity, thereby they can increase the metoprolol levels within the plasma, resulting in increased toxicity. So along with these drugs, metoprolol dose should be somewhat reduced to prevent cardiovascular side effects. Similarly, metoprolol shows an interaction with MAO inhibitors. MAO inhibitors are used as antidepressants, and these drugs can produce orthostatic hypotension. So when these MAO inhibitors are combined with metoprolol, it may lead to severe hypotension as well as severe bradycardia, syncope and vertigo in the patients. So again, these drugs should be carefully combined in order to prevent hypotensive side effects. Similarly, metoprolol produces bradycardia. So few of the drugs which produce bradycardia may interact with metoprolol. One of the drugs is the digitalis, that is having the digoxin. Similarly, CCBs, calcium channel blockers, and clonidine, which is an alpha-2 agonist. All these drugs are going to reduce the rate of contraction. They produce bradycardia. So when these drugs are combined with metoprolol, a severe bradycardia can be observed. How it is given? Metoprolol is available as extended release tablet or normal tablet, even IV solution. And it is available at the different dosing strengths from 12.5 to 200 mg. The dose of metoprolol depends on the type of clinical indication. This drug can be used in the treatment of angina, where the initial dose is 100 mg once daily. The dose may be slowly increased and the maximum dose is 400 mg per day. Similarly, for the treatment of hypertension, the initial dose is variable from 25 to 100 mg once daily, but the maximum dose is again 400 mg per day. In the treatment of heart failure, the dose of metoprolol is somewhat reduced. It can be used at an initial dose of 12.5 to 25 mg once daily, and the maximum dose in this heart failure is 200 mg per day. In this way, metoprolol is one of the important cardio-selective beta blocker that can be used in the various types of cardiovascular disorders. It can be used in the treatment of angina, heart failure, cardiac arrhythmias, hypertension. Even it can be given prophylactically in the treatment of myocardial infarction. In all these conditions, metoprolol can be given. This drug is a selective beta-1 antagonist. It blocks the beta-1 receptors located at the heart, thereby it reduces the rate as well as force of contraction. It also reduces the cardiac output, cardiac work, and cardiac oxygen consumption. All these collectively leads to increased cardiac efficiency. That's why this drug is useful in the treatment of cardiovascular disorders. But since this drug is going to reduce the force of contraction, thereby cardiac output, this drug should be carefully given in the treatment of heart failure. At a low dose, it can reduce the heart failure, but at a high dose, it can increase the risk of heart failure. And this drug should be initiated after the alpha blockers in the patients of pheochromocytoma. Metoprolol can increase the orthostatic hypotension produced by MAO inhibitors. And when this drug is given with digoxin, calcium channel blockers and clonidine, the bradycardia may be increased. And sudden withdrawal of metoprolol may increase the cardiovascular disorders as well as tachycardia, thyroid storm. And this drug can also antagonize the actions of epinephrine, thereby it can increase the anaphylactic reactions. Bradycardia, hypotension, drowsiness, fatigue are important side effects of metoprolol, and it can also increase the bronchospasm in the susceptible patients. So that's about this metoprolol. In our next video, we will come with another interesting drug. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.